for me, and I guess in a way you do.
Hello, my fellow viewers. Welcome back to Expert Media. Yes, I have come again in order to assist you with the latest instruction that was given by the Diversity Immigrant Visa Program for the 2020. However, the new instructions has been listed out, which is by the Department of State annually administers the statutory mandated diversity visa program in the section 203 of the Immigration and Nationality Act, provides a class of immigrants known as diversity immigrants from countries which historically low rates of immigration to the United States. All right, for the fiscal year 2020, 50,000 diversity visa will be available. There is no cost to register for the DV program. So, all right, applicants who are selected in the program will be eligible to qualify for a diversity visa. You understand that? However, the Department of State determines selectees through a randomized computer drawing. So the Department of State distributes diversity visas among six geographic regions, and no single country may receive more than 7% of these available DVs in any 1 year. So for the DV 2020, natives of the following countries are not eligible to apply because more than 50,000 natives of these countries immigrated to the United States in the previous 5 years: Bangladesh, Brazil, Canada, China mainland, and Colombia, Dominican Republic, El Salvador, Haiti, India, Jamaica, Mexico, Nigeria, Pakistan, Peru, Philippines, South Korea, United Kingdom, except Northern Ireland and its dependent territories, and Vietnam. Persons born in Hong Kong, Macau, and Taiwan are eligible. There were no changes in eligibility this year from the previous fiscal year. That's just it. And eligibility requirements, which is a requirement one: individuals born in countries native qualifies may be qualified to enter, which means if your spouse is born in a country whose your natives are eligible, and yes, you can claim your spouse country of birth, your spouse country of birth, provided that both are named on the selected entry, which means if during the process of your application you need to include your spouse during that process of the DV lottery, which is coming up on October, you need to enter your spouse information. If you not do that, if you after you won the lottery, or it's not even possible to win the lottery because you do not put someone who is eligible to carry along in order to win the DV lottery. So now what happened is you just need to, for examples, like countries like Jamaica, Brazil, okay, let me say Canada, who is not eligible, and someone from South Africa. Okay, let's say use South Africa as an example. Someone from your wife is from South Africa and then lives with you in Canada. So you can both apply for the DV lottery because South Africa is eligible to apply for the DV lottery. So I think that is clear. And also, where you were born, if you are born in a country whose natives are ineligible, but in which neither your parents was born or legally resident at the time of your birth, yes, you may claim the country of birth of one of your parents if it is a country whose natives are eligible for the DV 2020 program. I hope you understand that. Okay, for the entry period of this application, which is a 2020, for the 2020 program electronically, which you can apply at dvlottery.state.gov between noon Eastern Daylight Time, which is on Wednesday, October 3rd, which will be October 12th of 2019. However, so in order to get, now I'll be giving you instructions, the latest instructions on how to win the DV lottery, because with this instruction, if you can follow it strictly, you'll be able to win, or you'll have a chance, more chance to win the DV lottery. All right, welcome back to Expert Media again. We'll be giving you instructions on what the necessary information you need to complete your diversity visa lottery. Number one, you need your name, which is the last name or family name or first name or middle name, exactly as it appears on your passport. If you have only one name, it must be entered in the last name field. However, the gender, which is either you are male or female, you must put that, you must enter that as well. Then the birth date, which that's the day, month and year. Then the city where you were born, okay, and then the country where you were born, which is very important. Use the name of the country currently used for the place where you were born. Okay, so country of eligibility for the DV program, your country of eligibility will normally be the same of your country of birth or the country of your spouse, according to what I've said earlier on. All right, so after that, you need to get a recent photograph. So the recent photograph, which is have to be 600 by 600, and which is going to be in a plain background or white, pure white background. So that's part of the qualifications. So if you don't have that, or if you put a passport photograph that is not the diversity lottery requirement, then you will be disqualified. You need an entrant photograph which is a passport which has been taken within the last 6 months, and also for your spouse and all the children. So see submitting a digital photograph for compositional and technical specification, which I'll be providing that later in my video. All right, so after that, you get a mailing address, and your mailing address must be written well and must be a corrected one. However, although the diversity laboratory has stopped sending results to winners at their mailing address, so what they do right now is just use your confirmation. When you use your confirmation, then that's all. So when you use your confirmation number to check your entrance, if you have won, you get the result, and if you have not won, you get the result that you have not been selected. All right, so the mailing address should be corrected, and should be a correct one, and also country where you live in today, which means your present country where you are living, where you are sleeping and waking up. All right, so and the number 10, which is the phone number, then you have to enter your phone number and email address. So the email address should be an email address to which you have direct access, which you can access at any time, which you cannot forget the password, and will continue to have a direct access to eternity. So which means after we notify you selectees in May of next year, if you have been notified, then if your entry is selected and you respond to the notification of your selection through the entrance check status check. All right, so now after that, the level of education. So at least high level of education you have achieved as of today. So that's what the diversity vitality needs. So if you don't have that now, if possible, if you can get that within this period and October, that'll be fine. So you need a primary school only, number one, or some high school high school with no diploma, or high school with diploma, or vocational school certificate, or some university courses, or university degree or some graduate level courses, and also master's degree and some doctoral level courses and then doctorate. So if you have that, then you are qualified to apply for the DV lottery. All right, also the current marital status, if you are unmarried or married and then you're not or your spouse lives in the United States, or married, or you're separated, or widow, or divorced, or legally separated, then you have to indicate that. You have to let us know that. So also after that, if you have all those information, then you need to provide the number of children that will be coming with you to the United States, which means you need to put a number of children. If you're having one children, you have to put it there. If you're having two, you have to put it there. So because the only numbers of children that you entered in the entrance form if you have been a lucky winner, if you are one of the lucky winner, then the children will be going with you. However, so you have to put the accurate information. All right, so after that, the next information is after you have done that, you need to put your spouse information and the children's information as well. So selection of applicant based on the allocation of available visas as each region and countries, the Department of State will randomly select individuals by computer from among qualified entries. All right, so by the time this the result will be checked, which is around May 7th, then you'll be able to know that if you have been selected or not. All right, so I think this is there's a particular information that has been added to this this online application DV Visa lottery that I've not said anything about it. So what was added was that any applicant must have his or her international passport data page. So you need to have a page, or you just need a passport number, because the passport number will be required during the process when you are making this application, so which is very important. So and this was this was done all because of this some consultants that embezzles money, that scams people. So because of the scammers, so they have to change this information, and they have to add this information in order to reduce that, and it will also reduce number of people who have been applying for the DV lottery. You understand? So it will reduce that, and then that will also give those who have those information that was required will also have a chance of winning the DV lottery. All right, I think that's a good information. So kindly like this video, share the video, and also subscribe to our channel to get more videos. Thank you. It's caught in the crossfire.